略显憔悴的纳瓦尼站在律师身旁，法官宣读指控时，45岁的纳瓦尼看起来不为所动，自顾自低头翻阅法庭文件。纳瓦尼目前正在莫斯科东方一处拘禁营地服2年半的刑期，因为他违反过往罪行的假释条件，如今他又被俄国法官判处大规模诈欺和藐视法庭有罪，判刑9年，罚款120万卢布，大约新台币33万元。对此，纳瓦尼表示罪行全是捏造的，为的是阻挠他的政治雄心，并痛批俄国总统普丁害怕面对事实。
This is not a surprise that Putin would like to keep Alexei in prison for as long as he is in power. We are completely sure that this is his direct order to imprison Alexei.
纳瓦尼入狱之前一直带头反对俄罗斯执政党领导俄国境内最大规模的反普丁示威抗议，2020年搭机时还曾被下毒险些送命，被送往德国治疗，去年康复后又返回俄国，立刻被当局逮捕，而他的处境也引发西方国家对俄罗斯实施制裁。而随着俄军入侵乌克兰，西方国家也祭出前所未见的制裁措施。
It is just impossible to turn your head away and step aside when you see with your own eyes what is happening in Ukraine and what is happening inside Russia. We see a lot of people who are protesting right now, though it is very scary. So this is why I am completely sure that there are a lot of people in Russia who are against the war and against Putin himself.
尽管战争爆发后，有许多俄罗斯民众上街抗议，表达反战诉求，不过在俄罗斯的政治精英阶层却几乎没有反对普丁的声音。有专家就表示，因为普丁已经建立一个体系，并被极度忠诚的拥护者包围，他和拥护者都相信西方世界企图摧毁俄罗斯。即使认为普丁并不正确，也没有人敢提出反驳或行动，因为每个人都必须专心自保。华人新闻孙颖玲综合报道。
请订阅、按赞、分享环宇新闻 YouTube 频道，并开启小铃铛，及时掌握全球时事与最新趋势。